Michaela is a controversial girl, shooting lions in Africa and romping through the Czech press at home as well as the UK's Daily Mail. Today she's after the uncontroversial Muntjac and maybe a fallow, and she is going out with one of the country's top Muntjac merchants, stalker Paul Childerley. We are on ground in Hertfordshire and Michaela is staying uncharacteristically quiet as we stalk the woodland margins on this family-owned estate. It doesn't take long and we're onto one. It is an awkward shot. We disturb two fallow. They're bucks, so Michaela doesn't take that shot. Now, with the fallow out of the way, nothing can stop her excitement bubbling over.
I just got it!
Okay, what did you get?
I don't know.
The Muntjac buck.
Michaela and Paul have only just met, so how does Paul know that a client like her can shoot straight?
That's the beauty of having Facebook. You can check somebody out before they come hunting, see how much they hunted before, because it just makes your life so much easier when they're competent with a rifle, and also when you give somebody a rifle, straight away they pick up correctly, they know how it works. You can tell who's a hunter and not a hunter. And that was a good shot. Brilliant shot that was. So well done.
I want to try to eat it. Will you cook it for me?
So have you seen a deer like this before, Michaela? What is it?
No, never. That's why I was dreaming about this one, and that's why I messaged you. I want a Muntjac because I've seen them only on the Facebook and I was jealous on the hunters who already have one. So now I'm really happy because I also have one and I really wonder how it tastes like.
Look at them.
Yeah, I need a trophy. I need a mounted you have.
Yeah, shoulder mount, yeah.
They're always in thick bushes, thick cover. And they never break across the field, so you know they're always, and they're so alert compared to the Chinese in a row. Their senses are, I think, phenomenal. So, yeah, and especially when there's more than one of you hunting them, they're difficult. They're clever little guys.
We walk to another patch of woodland, and Michaela spots another culinary delight.
These,
yeah,
magic mushrooms.
Yeah, eat it.
No, thank you.
I think it's a magic mushroom.
Magic.
Who's gonna eat it? We will see a lot of deers, I guarantee you.
Paul is in a spin about the pheasants here. Too much deer stalking disturbs them. He talks to Phil, the gamekeeper who runs the pheasant shoot.
There ain't much fallow out here, I don't want to push all these woods out. You got anything up your end that's out in the fields or whatever?
It turns out he does, and he agrees to come and pick us up. Paul and Michaela have a special commission to shoot a fallow for the freezer of the family that owns the place. We need a vehicle to get us to the other end of the estate. While we walk back to the track, Michaela says how similar this is to deer hunting at home in the Czech Republic.
Yeah, well, it's kind of similar, but we don't have a Muntjac, so... But yeah... I hunt in the Czech Republic also. We walk a lot sometimes. We sit on a high seat. It's up. What mood do you have? But yeah, it's kind of similar with the Czech Republic hunting. In Czech Republic, people like a tradition, so they usually put a branch on its mouth, which means something like last meal, and it's some kind of a respect for animal. I don't know if you guys doing it here.
We have time to take lots of photos of Michaela's first Muntjac before Phil arrives. He drives us until we find a deer to stalk into. It doesn't take long. And down it goes. The shot sends yet more fallow scuttling. Paul shot this one. He does not feel he had to work hard for it.
Maximum reward for minimum effort, basically.
Michaela is on a photography mission. Trophy is much more important in the Czech Republic than in the UK. Paul sets up the animal for a photo in the way that his clients usually like.
Mum and baby.
Yeah, God.
This is what the Daily Mail's going to say. You've got the mummy and the baby.
Michaela says the Muntjac stalking experience is similar to a kind of stalking she knows well.
It reminds me of roe deer hunting. They are like small animals. Yeah.
Yeah, I'd say it's like hunting roe deer. You can stalk them, you can call them, and you can sit in a high seat and wait for them. So yeah.
It was very hard, you know.
Okay.
I had to wake up in the morning and put the makeup on.
Now let's take a break from deer. There's another good reason to bring Michaela and Paul together. They're both champion kickboxers. So back at the shooting lodge Paul keeps for his guests, they agree to put the gloves on and show off.
Oh, WPKA, ISDO and some else.
Can you compete with that?
Yeah, WPKA, WMA, yeah.
So you're basically
about the same sort of level.
They start sparring. They are being ultra careful, so I have added some sound effects to make it more exciting.
Ow! 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 Ow!
So have we concluded who is the best fighter?
Honestly, he's man. So I would have to kick his balls in the right time and have a look, and then he's done, and if I don't get it...
It makes your eyes water. Now it's the following morning. Paul and Michaela are in Bedfordshire, where he is going to take her out after Britain's other small deer, a Chinese water deer. The Muntjac got a strong reaction from the world when Michaela posted the photos on Facebook. People all over the planet wanted to know what it was and where it came from. And of course, how could she be so cruel to shoot such a little one? Michaela is expecting even more from the CWD.
Oh, they will say it's baby because it's a small deer, it's very small deer. Smaller than a roe deer, and I got the troubles with a roe deer because it's a baby. At least Daily Mail said it's a baby, so we'll see what they're gonna say about Chinese water deer.
Despite the chance of media hysteria, it's a beautiful morning and the deer are standing out in the fields. Michaela and Paul are soon crawling into place for a shot at a cull buck, but there's a problem. There is a man wheeling his bicycle across the field. It spooks the deer, and Paul gets on the phone to the landowner to find out if it's a trespasser.
Okay, cool, that's right. I don't know either.
It turns out it's fine, but it means Paul has to rethink his stalking strategy. He takes us up another hedgerow on these big fields, glancing ahead, and Paul spots not one but two animals next to each other. To get into the right place for a safe shot means a crawl into the ditch. It's a longer drop than Paul expects. The problem now is that the animals are lying down. Paul tries to make them stand up, but they have already been disturbed by an unexpected bicyclist, and this is too much for them. Happily, Paul spots another one further away under a hedge. The landowner wants a significant reduction in numbers, so any animal is a good animal. It's another good shot, proving that Michaela can hit them from a distance. Michaela is happy, but she would have preferred a buck.
Yeah, like a big thief. I need a male, you gotta find me a male.
Michaela has had a good couple of days with Paul. Two outings, three deer, and, well, a submission. Keeping her warm all the way through is this film's sponsor, clothing company Shooter King. And if you want to go stalking with Paul, visit childerleysporting.co.uk.